Hi, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Rongjun Sun from the Sociology Department, Cleveland State University. I think you, as you may have heard, you know, I just got a cold, unfortunately, and my voice sounds a little bit husky, and plus my accent, so that may add some difficulty to your hearing. I hope this will go smoothly, and this is my first time doing this online webinar. So I'm a little nervous, and I hope, you know, I mean, we can have this go well. Well, this module, okay, it's called World Income and Health Inequality. This is for one of my upper elective classes in social. This is for the class of globalization. This is offered to many of our majors as an elective. The purpose here of this module is to show students inequality in income and health, to do an international comparative study to look at these two dimensions of inequality separately first, and then I'm going to show them how these two dimensions, income and health, can be related. So that's the purpose. In terms of objectives, well, in terms of the material, the content, substantive objective, there are four objectives here. The first one is the students will learn how to investigate income inequality worldwide. The second objective is to investigate inequality in health status worldwide. The idea of the first two objectives is to show students how big the gap is between the rich and the poor nations in the average income and in health status. The third question is to look at the relationship between the two inequalities above. That is it true that people living in richer nations also live longer or healthier? Is there such a relationship? And that's number three. And the last objective is to see if there is a relationship, I say, between average income and health status of the population, that this relationship hold for all income levels, especially for the rich nations. The question is, among the rich nations, is this still true that those with a higher, relatively higher income, I mean here when we talk about the rich nations, their income, average income, is at least more than $20,000 a year. Even among this rich group, is there still such a relationship? That is, the richer the country is, the longer or the healthier the people are. Is that still true? And that is the last research question I want to explore. In terms of qualitative skills, in this module, basically I want to show students how to do some basic analysis in Excel. Well, here, I mean, to do this work, students are not required to learn any separate statistical package, you know, like SPSS or anything else, but just Excel. And so I hope that, you know, so they can have some kind of a idea and a confidence in using the most common software to do some basic quantitative analysis. In terms of quantitative skills, here I listed the first one is I want to show them how to sort a single variable and examine its distribution in Excel. The second objective is to show them how to do some within group calculation, to calculate within group means. As you will see later, after we have gotten the variables in income and health status, I mean here, we're gonna look at life expectancy. We're gonna ask students to calculate, for instance, like the mean, the average income, or the average life expectancy of the top 20 countries. Okay, how do you calculate the top 20 and then the bottom 20? How to calculate the mean within those two groups? This is what I'm going to show them. Then the third objective under quantitative skills is to show students how to find out the correlation between two variables, in this case, income on the one hand and health status or life expectancy on the other. And then the second, and within this category, I will also show them how to make scatter plots, okay, to look at the relationship between two variables, okay. And these are, I would say, the two dimensions of the objectives that I hope to achieve in this module. Now let's take a look at the data, the data source. The data I use for this module is from Data Finder, and that is from the Population Reference Bureau's website. And here I provided the address of this website. And here I would like to take a few moments to show you the website and then how to download the web, download and export the data from their website to Excel. I think in my class, I did it for students, so they don't have to do this. I think in your case, it's up to you, you know, whether you want students to do this from the very beginning or you want to prepare the data for them. Okay, now here's the link. And I have already gotten the, well, maybe before we go to the link, for this module, let me just first talk about the two variables I'm going to use for this module. The first variable for income, that for this project, I'm going to use gross national income, PPP per capita. And this is provided on this Data Finder website. That is an indicator of average income. The measure for health status I'm using for this module is life expectancy. Life expectancy, I think maybe before we ask students to download the data, maybe we first need to give them some idea about what two variables are about and how they are measured. For instance, like the income measure, GNI PPP. PPP stands for purchasing power parity. The idea of a PPP is to take account of different living standard and inflation. So that can make the international comparison compatible because we know in different parts of the world for the same kind of a product or service, the price can be totally different depending on the living standard. So that has to be taken into account. And this is what this measure, the so-called PPP measure, is doing. The second measure, life expectancy, that is one typical measure for health status. That is, we can say, the average years, number of years, an individual is expected to live from a population. Okay, these are the basic definitions for these two terms. Okay, so these are the two variables I'm going to use for this module. Now let me show you the website from the Data Finder website. Okay, here is the Population Reference Bureau's website. Okay, Data Finder. Well, since this is international comparative studies, so basically here what you want to look at is in the column of international, and what we need for this project is income and life expectancy. For income, here you can just click economic under international. Okay, let me click it. Okay, under economic, you can see here we have a few measures. And what we want for this project is the third one, GNI per capita. Okay, and this is the variable. And if you click it, click this link, and there will be a table. in this table, well, I think here I have to, I think I have to move this control panel so that you can see. Okay. So now you can see there are just two columns in the table. And the one is the name of all the countries. I think about 205 countries listed here. And then the second column lists all the income, okay, the average income, okay, for each country. But for some country, you can see the income level is missing, okay. Well, this table, these two columns, can be exported to Excel. And if you look up here, at the right corner, there is a logo like Excel. If you click on this, okay, it's going to ask you whether you want to open it, okay? And if you say open, I'll click OK. Okay, let me move again the control panel, move it out of the way so you see what the output looks like, okay? And this is what the output looks like in Excel file. You have location, that's basically the country's names. I think this is the column you want to keep, column A. Or column B, there are all the countries, we don't need this. Column C, that's for the year. Okay, in this case 2009. And then currency, column E is income. And this is the column you also want to keep. So basically, I think for the purpose of this project, you only need to keep two columns. The column A, country's name, and then column E, that is the income, the average income. Okay. So I think what you can do easily is just to highlight the columns you don't want to keep and then delete them. Okay. And then you can move, you know, the column. Oops. Okay. So what you have is just two columns from this file. Similarly, let's go back to the website. Well, let's see if I can. Okay. Okay. Let's go back. This is the Data Finder website. Okay. We just downloaded this table. Now let's go back to find the life expectancy variable. For life expectancy, well, you just click the heading above economic, that is demographics. Okay. So if you click demographics, you're going to see life expectancy. That is here. Okay. Somewhere in the middle. Life expectancy at birth by gender. Okay. And this is the variable we're going to use as an indicator of health status. Okay. If you click life expectancy here. Okay. Let me click. Okay. After you click, well, now we get 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. Okay. Again, the first column, it comes with names, and then you have life expectancy at the birth for both sexes, for females or for males. Okay. Well, I think to make the analysis simpler, we may only need to keep just one of the three measures of life expectancy. And in my class, I just keep the average life expectancy for both sexes. Okay. For both sexes, okay, and in this case, if I only want to keep one of them, and you can here ask Excel or this website only to export the life expectancy for both sexes, and to do this, there's one good feature on this page. If you look up here, okay, filters, and there is a button change. What you do is you click change. Okay, and under gender, currently all three boxes are checked. That means you want to export life expectancy for all three of them. Okay. But in my case, if I only want to keep the life expectancy for both sexes, so I will uncheck females and males. Okay, and then you click update this report. I hope it will update. Okay, Okay, now you see there's only one column left, I mean for life expectancy for both sexes, and you do the same thing. Okay, then you click the Excel button, okay, as we did for income variable, and then you're gonna see the same output, okay, the same output. Okay, so the first names of all the countries, okay, and then here column F, that gives you what? The life expectancy, okay, for all the countries, okay. Again, for some countries, I mean, life expectancy is missing, okay. So what you need to do is you need to, first of all, merge these two variables into the same table, okay, into the same table. And what I need to do is I just highlight, for instance, I will make a copy of the single column of F column. That is where the life expectancy is, okay? And then I will select the values. I can scroll down from the top, okay, to the end, the last country, okay. The last one is, okay, Zimbabwe, okay? So I highlight this, okay? Now let me scroll which part I highlight. Okay, this is the part I highlighted. And then I will just copy and then move to here. That is the first table where we had the income table. And then you paste. Okay. Well, here you do not have to worry about the order of the countries. In both tables, they use the same number of countries, the same countries. And they are ordered in the same way, okay? So that means after you copy paste the life expectancy matches, okay, the income, okay, and it belongs to the same country. So now you have in the final spreadsheet, you're gonna have, you know, three columns, one for country, one for income, and one for life expectancy, okay? And of course, some countries, I mean, they either miss one piece of information or both. And then what you have to do is you have to, because later on we're going to do correlation analysis, that requires the availability of both pieces of information. Okay. So then we have to what? Delete all those countries that have any one piece of information that is missing. Okay. So in this case, I'm going to delete Andorra. Okay, so this is what you can do, just delete it, okay? And then you're gonna have more, okay? Just keep doing this, and eventually you're gonna get a complete data with variables. And this is the, not this one, okay? Here, okay, this is what the final data looks like, okay? This is here I just only keep both countries with complete information, okay? I think totally, we end up with 100, 174 countries, right, 174 countries, okay, with complete information, okay. That is how your download and export it from the Data Finder website, okay, so that's the first step. Now let's go back to the PowerPoint. Okay, so here we have already downloaded the data, okay, the two variables. Now let's start the data analysis part. Well, the first goal is to look at the inequality in income. Okay, what do I do here? To do income, well, actually in my PowerPoint file, of you know, expected results. Okay, so here I ask students, you know, if they have already got the data, can they find the highest income per capita in the world, and then the lowest, find the number. Okay, and also I will ask them to provide the country's name, and then what's the difference between the top one and the bottom one. Okay, and then I wanted them to find out the average income of the top 10 and the bottom 10 countries. again, calculate the difference. I think that will give them an idea of how striking or how big the income gap is between the richest and the poorest nations in the world. Okay, let's do this. In order to do this, to do income, let's go to, okay, this is my spreadsheet. Okay, to do this, well, first of all, we have to sort the variable. To sort this, I think usually to be safe, I would like, you know, first, before we touch the data, to make a copy, okay, of the original table. And then move them, make a copy, okay, into a separate sheet, okay. The reason is, if in case in the middle we mess up with the data, okay, we still have the original copy, okay, we can come back to. We don't have to re-download the data again, okay. So this is just another copy. And to do the income level, what you need to do is you need to highlight all the income data from this column, highlight all the numbers, okay, the income level numbers, and then in a cell, okay, let me move this control, okay, yeah, so there is here like a funnel, okay, you can sort and filter, okay, that's where you can do the sorting of the variables, okay, just click here, sort. Here, I say we want to sort from the largest to the smallest, okay? Okay. Then there is a window popping up asking whether you want to expand the selection. Here, you'll want to click yes, okay, just click sort, okay? Click sort, okay. So now what it does is now all the countries are sorted by the level of income. Okay, so the highest is Luxembourg, okay, with 59,590, the average income, okay, in 2009, followed by Macau, okay, 57, okay, and then you can see some other countries, okay, down the list. And then since the highest is 59,590, okay, so here students can now fill in, you know, this blank. Similarly, they can find the lowest from the, might be from the Excel, okay, from the list, okay, so you just go down to the bottom and you're gonna see what the bottom is Liberia, okay, 290, okay, and then they can fill out this blank, 290, and of course they can calculate the difference, okay, so here I'm gonna skip it. Okay, and next I want to show you how to calculate the top 10 and the bottom 10, the average income, okay, of these two groups, okay. To do this, that can also be done here in Excel. If, since we are already at the bottom, let's first do the bottom 10, okay. What we do is you highlight the bottom 10 countries, okay. I think I'm going to start from here. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. Okay. These are the 10 countries. Okay. 10 countries. You highlight this bottom 10 countries. Okay. If we want to calculate the average, here what we do is, okay, let me re-highlight. I think I lost it. Okay. What we do is we go to here. There is a button called auto sum, okay, auto sum, and the second option is average, okay, so if you click average, and that should give you the average of the 10 countries we just highlighted, okay, here I got the number, 5627, okay, that's the average for the bottom 10, and similarly, we can do the top 10, okay, top 10, you start from the beginning, the top. And I think the 10th is Australia, okay? And you do the same thing, okay? Go to the same place, auto sum, select average, and click average, okay? I think we should, have gotten the number for the F. That is at the bottom. Okay, here, 47,649. Okay, so following these steps, now we can fill out. Okay, let me move this again. Okay, now we can fill out the average, the group average, for the bottom 10 and the top 10. And of course, students can also figure out the difference. Okay, so that is how to calculate, how to sort the data, and how to find the top first and the bottom one, and how to find the average for the top 10 and the bottom 10. Okay, this is for income. Okay, let's go back to the procedure. Okay. So we have already done the first one, sorting the data, okay, and then we've already done calculating the mean income. The next is to do life expectancy, and that basically is to repeat the same steps we just did, okay. So the same idea, you just need to, this time, let me go back to here, okay. This time you just need to what? To sort the data instead of by income, but by life expectancy, okay. So what I do here, let me delete, okay, the numbers we just calculated, okay, to make it clean. Okay, delete it. What we do here is we just highlight, now highlight life expectancy. Okay, you highlight the life expectancy, all the numbers in this column, and then still go to the place of sorting. And we want to sort again from the largest to the smallest. We'll do the same thing. Okay, let me move this. And okay, let's just click sort. Okay, now if you go come back to the top, okay, you see something has changed. Now all the countries are sorted by what? By life expectancy. Okay, now the top one is not Luxembourg anymore, okay, with the highest average income, but with the highest life expectancy, which is 83, okay, and Luxembourg is somewhere here, at the 18th place, okay, with the life expectancy of 80, okay. Okay, after you sort the data, life expectancy, you know, from highest to lowest, now you can repeat. Ask students to repeat the process, the same process, to find the highest, lowest, and also to calculate the two group means. Okay, and here I will just skip. Okay, this part. Okay. Now let's come back to the okay to here to the two procedure. Okay, so we have done first, second, and the third. Okay, life expectancy, and the last analysis is basically to see how we're gonna establish any kind of a relationship, okay, to look at whether there is any correlation between these two countries. The first thing to do is, if your students have already learned, you know, some basic statistics, that there is one measure that is called correlation coefficient, R, okay, that is basically about the strength of the correlation between two quantitative variables. Okay, the idea is for the coefficients that is between -1 and +1. The basic idea is the closer the value either to -1 or +1, the stronger the relationship. On the other hand, if the coefficient is closer to 0, that means there's very weak or virtually no relationship. Okay, so here we can use Excel to calculate this correlation coefficient R. Okay. To do this, we just need to use one command. Okay, that's provided by Excel. Okay, here I just type in the command that is CORREL. Okay, that is for correlation. And here you need to specify the range of the two variables. Okay, so in my case, you need to cover the first value of income from the first value, in that case, the location is B2, okay, up to the last value, I think that is B176, the last country, separated by comma, okay, and then you specify the second variable for life expectancy, that's from C2, okay, to C176, okay, close your parentheses, and then you hit enter. Here you got the coefficient, that is 0.67, okay. 0.67, I would say, is there is some kind of a moderate, okay, correlation, okay, close to strong, I would say, correlation, okay, between income and life expectancy, okay. But it is still abstract. I think to show students really what the picture looks like, it's better to show a graph, okay, and that is the next analysis I want to perform here, that is to make a scatter plot. Okay, to make a scatter plot. To make a scatter plot in Excel is pretty easy. What you need to do is just to highlight the two columns of data. And then to make a scatter plot. Okay. Okay, insert scatter, okay, scatter plot. And let's pick the basic scatter plot, okay. And this is what the chart looks like, okay. So here you have on the horizontal axis, it has the income, average income level, on the vertical axis, the life expectancy, okay. And it seems like there is, especially if you start from the low level of income, okay. It seems like the higher the income, the higher life expectancy, okay? But there is some kind of trend, and that is after a certain level of income, let's say if we cut it at about 20,000, okay? And you're going to see basically now the line is basically flat, okay? And not very much differentiation, okay, between those countries with income, average income higher than 20,000, okay? I think this is something we want to point out to students, okay? And also here on my handout, I showed, you know, maybe we want to, you know, recalculate the correlation coefficient for the top 20 countries, and then redo the scatter plot for the top 20 countries, okay? And well, here, this is not complicated. What we need to do this is, okay, now let me delete this, okay, delete this chart so that we can remake a new chart for the top 20 countries. To do this, we just need to come back to reorder the variable by income. And I will just highlight the income variable, and then to do the sort again. From largest to highest. Oops. Yes, okay. Okay, we'll come back with Luxembourg at the top. If we do the top 20, and we just need to highlight the top 20 countries, okay, their income and life expectancy, and then to do a separate scatter plot. Okay, here is what the chart looks like for the top 20 countries, okay? And this country with the lowest life expectancy, that is Bahrain, okay, number point, Bahrain, if you look at it here, the Excel, okay, with average income of 33,690 with a life expectancy of 75, okay, that is like an outsider, okay, outlier, okay, and then here, this country, okay, 45,000 with $40 with 78 years of life expectancy. That is in the United States. Okay, and here, United States, I mean, compared to other countries, it has higher income in many other countries in the top 20. Okay, but in terms of the health outcome, life expectancy, okay, actually, it's at the bottom. Okay, of this group. Okay, so at least I think if you look at without the outlier of Bahrain, just look at the other 19 countries, at least I think we can say there's no clear relationship between income and the life expectancy or health status. I think that's kind of a conclusion we can draw. Okay, and also, of course, you can ask students to calculate again a correlation coefficient, okay, for the top 20 countries. They do the same thing, okay, as I just did. Okay. Okay, I think that is the, basically the analysis part. Okay, you know, after students have done the analysis, they should be able to get to the result part. Okay, to fill out all those blanks. Okay, the average life expectancy. Okay, the bottom, the top, and also they should be able to find the correlation coefficient and to make scatter plots. Okay, that is the result. Okay. Finally, conclusion. Here, I would like students, you know, to report their findings and to give some explanation about, first of all, what is the conclusion about world income inequality. Okay, and then the second is what's the gap in terms of life expectancy between different countries. And then also I want to ask them, is this true overall, people living in richer countries live longer? Okay, I think generally that is true. Okay? And here I will ask them why. Why you think, okay, people living in countries with average income of more than $20,000 live longer than those living in a country with average income of $300? What makes that difference? Okay, if you talk about money makes a difference, why? Okay, this is the kind of question I think we can ask them to think about. And also in the end, I also want to ask them, when you look at the top 20, the richest countries in the world, did you see the same relationship, okay, between income and the life expectancy? Based on the result, it seems like the answer is no. If no, then the question is why? Can you think of any other factors that you think now become more important, okay, in terms of, you know, that can have impact on people's health, or in this case, more particularly life expectancy? Okay, what makes the difference? Okay, so these are kind of things I think I would like them to think about after they have, you know, run the analysis, down the look at the data. Okay, and well, the above is what I would like, what I showed in the classroom to show them how to do the analysis. And after I do the demo, I give them a separate assignment. That is what they need to do. Here, the setup is the same. Okay, again, the same topic. Okay, but I ask them to do with one different variable. Okay, for income, they still use the same variable. Okay, because there's only one income variable. Okay, provided in the data set. They still use GNI PPP, but for life, for health status, instead of a life expectancy, I ask them to use infant mortality rate, which is another good measure of the overall health status of the population. Okay, so that I just ask them to duplicate what I just did. Okay, in my demo, and usually they turn out well. The students can do this. Or can do this. In my assignment, okay, so I will, you know, give them, this is the setup of the assignment, okay, I will not repeat what I have here, okay. So I will ask them, I think, actually here, for the first group, there's some slight change, okay, in the requirement. In my demo, I asked them to count the top 10, bottom 10. Here, I asked them to do the top 20, bottom 20, okay. And when we do the correlation, in my demo, I did the top 20. Here, I asked them to do the top 30. Okay, and virtually the results won't change very much. Okay, they remain the same. Okay, but it just makes some difference. That is, you know, they can challenge them a little bit. that's basically about this module. Okay, and in the end, I have two slides where I show some other alternative sources of data you may want to check out and may want to consider. I mean, they also provide information on, you know, between or within country inequalities. Okay, that may be something you want to, you know, to check out. I think that's all I want to say. Okay, for this module. So.
Well, thank you, Rongjun. I was a very informative and very well put explanation of how to help students use Excel and easily available data. We have no questions for you. unless someone wants to send us one. Copies of the slide and the recording will be available tomorrow. So keep your eye out on your email for that announcement. And they'll be posted to the ICPSR site, and we'll also post it to the Teaching with Data site. And I do have a question. The question is, about how long does it take to walk through the exercise in a classroom?
Well, in my class, I mean, typically it's 1 hour. 1 hour, I think, is enough. Usually to save some time, you know, you may want to download the data first and put them in Excel, you know, like what I showed here. You'll have the three columns ready, you know, country, income, life expectancy, have them ready. And start from there, I think you will have enough time to cover it within 1 hour.
Okay. Well, those are all the questions that I have for you, Rongjun.
Great.
So I guess if we have no other questions, I think we can say thank you very much for attending, and look for announcements of other webinars that we're going to be having on this topic. We make the announcement through our OR list and also through our Teaching with Data listserv. And thank you, Rongjun, for taking the time to share your expertise with us. And keep your eye out on your email for announcements of the webinar recording and the slides, which will be made tomorrow. I got another question.
Yes.
Can you take another question, Rongjun?
Sure.
Okay. The question is, did you calculate coefficients by one country each time or 20 countries?
Okay. In order to calculate the correlation, you have to have a group of countries. So in my demo, I did the top 10. And then in my assignment, I asked them the top 20. You have to have multiple countries in order to calculate the correlation. Because the correlation is about relationship between countries. So that's the answer. Is that clear?
Yeah, I think that's totally clear, because you can't do it one by one, can you?
Right. No.
Okay. And I see no other questions coming in. And you have other resources on your slides for folks who are looking for data. And, of course, yeah. teachingwithdata.org is a resource that can be used as well.
Yes.
Okay, well, I think I'm going to end our webinar at this point and thank everyone for being here, and we look forward to seeing you at our next webinar.
Great. Thank you, Sue.
Thank you, Rongjun.